नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट टॉपिक नंबर 1.8 इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। नाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक लेट अस कंसीडर टू चार्ज पार्टिकल्स। वन चार्ज इज चार्ज क्यू एट पॉइंट पी विच इज अ पॉइंट चार्ज, अ वेरी स्मॉल चार्ज पार्टिकल, एंड द अदर चार्ज इज क्यू at point O, which is the origin of the coordinate system. Now, as there are two charge particles separated by distance r, we know that the force will act, and that force is given by F is equal to k, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught product of charge upon square of the distance between them. So this is the force between these two charge particles. Here there is a vector sign, so we have to put a unit vector for the direction of that force. So here we have applied a Coulomb's law to find the force. Now this is the force between the two charge particles. Now we want the formula for electric field. So now we know that the force on this charge particle at point P is due to Q, and there is nothing in between these two charge particles. That means there is a free space. Still, this charge particle acts force on this charge, means there must be some connection between the two charge particle so that the force acts. So what is that thing which links these two charge particles, which is responsible for that force? So here that is nothing but the electric field. The electric field of this charge is linked with this charge particle which is at point Q. So if I say, if there is nothing here at point P, that means if I remove this charge which is at point P, then what will remain at point P? So we can definitely say that now at point P there is an electric field of charge capital Q which is at point O. So definitely we can say that the electric field is there. So we can say that now, removing the charge particle Q from this formula of force, what will remain at point P? The electric field. So simply remove this charge Q at point P, and the remaining things will give the formula for the electric field. So finally, we can say that the electric field at distance r is value of k into q upon r square. You can see here the small q is removed, and when the small q is removed, there remains the electric field. Unit vector r is the direction of the electric field. As we have studied that the force is a vector quantity, and so the electric field is also a vector quantity. So the direction is also important. So this is the formula for the electric field due to charge Q at distance r, which is at point P. Now let us give this equation number 2, which is the equation of electric field. And earlier we obtained the equation of force for the same situation, which is equation number 1. Now if we'll compare equation number 1 and 2, then you will get the force F is equal to Q into E, comparing both the equation. Again see here how we can compare these two equations. See here, this is the equation of force. If I'll remove this charge from राइट हैंड साइड देन इट विल कम टूवर्ड्स दिस डायरेक्शन एफ अपॉन क्यू एंड वॉट विल रिमेन हीयर. सो नाउ वेन दिस चार्ज स्मॉल क्यू इज ब्रॉट टूवर्ड्स लेफ्ट साइड वी गेट एफ बाय क्यू ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड एंड वॉट रिमेन ऑन द राइट साइड दिस मच पार्ट विच इज नथिंग बट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. यू कैन सी द इक्वेशन नंबर 2. सो हियर रिमेन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो वी कैन से दैट ई इज इक्वल टू एफ बाय क्यू एंड इफ यू मेक द सब्जेक्ट एफ देन वॉट विल हैपन एफ इज इक्वल टू दिस क्यू विल कम हियर ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड सो इट विल बी क्यू इंटू ई. सो फोर्स इज नथिंग बट क्यू इंटू ई. इन अनदर वे आई कैन एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ दिस फॉर्मूला एफ इज इक्वल टू क्यू इंटू ई ऑब्टेन. यू कैन सी हियर दिस मच पार्ट इज नथिंग बट इट इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई एंड दिस इज क्यू. दिस इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड दिस इज क्यू. सो ई इंटू क्यू एंड ऑन लेफ्ट साइड देर इज एफ. सो एफ इज इक्वल टू ई इंटू क्यू. सो दिस इज द न्यू फॉर्मूला फॉर द फोर्स बट इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड अ चार्ज पार्टिकल. सो यू कैन इजिली रिमेंबर द फॉर्मूला फॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इन दिस वे. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर द फोर्स अकॉर्डिंग टू कूलम्स लॉ इन विच देर आर टू चार्ज पार्टिकल्स बट इफ यू रिमूव वन ऑफ द चार्ज सपोज इफ आई रिमूव दिस स्मॉल क्यू देन दिस बिकम्स द फॉर्मूला फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ चार्ज कैपिटल क्यू एंड इफ आई रिमूव दिस चार्ज कैपिटल क्यू देन देर रिमेन्स ओनली चार्ज स्मॉल क्यू. सो अगेन दिस इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड बट इट इज फॉर चार्ज स्मॉल क्यू. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू चार्ज स्मॉल क्यू इफ दिस कैपिटल क्यू इज रिमेन. सो यू कैन इजिली रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला. नाउ अबाउट दिस फॉर्मूला एफ इज इक्वल टू क्यू इन टू ई. यू कैन इजिली रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो दैट वेन वी पुट अ चार्ज क्यू इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड फोर्स विल एक्ट. अ चार्ज इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड देन देर एक्ट्स अ फोर्स एफ. सी दिस कंसेप्ट इज क्वाइट सिमिलर टू दैट दैट इफ देर इज अ मैग्नेट एंड इफ सपोज देर इज अ नॉर्थ पोल दिस साइड नॉर्थ और साउथ एनी वन. सो इफ देर इज अ नॉर्थ पोल टूवर्ड्स दिस साइड एंड इफ आई पुट सम आयन ऑब्जेक्ट और आयन पार्टिकल हियर देन वॉट हैपन्स फोर्स विल एक्ट ऑन दिस पार्टिकल. वाई इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई दिस मैग्नेट. सो अ पार्टिकल इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड हियर अ पार्टिकल ऑफ आयन विच इज इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड सो फोर्स एक्ट्स. सो दिस इज अबाउट द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड बट हियर दिस इज अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. अ चार्ज पार्टिकल विच इज इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड देन डेफिनेटली वॉट विल हैपन द फोर्स विल एक्ट. नाउ वी नो दैट द यूनिट ऑफ फोर्स इज न्यूटन एंड यूनिट ऑफ चार्ज इज कूलम. सो वॉट इज द यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई. सो यू कैन इजिली मेक आउट दैट यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई मस्ट बी न्यूटन पर कूलम. वाई बिकॉज इफ आई मेक द सब्जेक्ट ई हियर वंस अगेन सी विच वी हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर. सो ई इज इक्वल टू एफ बाय क्यू. यू कैन सी हियर दिस ई इज नथिंग बट इट इज एफ अपॉन क्यू. सो इन दैट मैनर वी कैन से दैट यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज न्यूटन पर कूलम. कूलम. सो वन यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज न्यूटन पर कूलम एंड द अदर यूनिट इज वोल्ट पर मीटर. व्हाई दिस यूनिट इज वोल्ट पर मीटर ऑल्सो, सो दैट वी विल कम टू नो इन चैप्टर नंबर 2. सो नाउ वी कैन इजीली डिफाइन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. द रीजन अराउंड द चार्ज इन विच द इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज इज प्रिवेलिंग इज कॉल्ड द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑफ द चार्ज. मीन्स इफ विल पुट अ चार्ज पार्टिकल देन वी गेट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अराउंड इट. नाउ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट रिमार्क्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. रिमार्क्स मीन्स सम प्रॉपर्टीज और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. नाउ वी हैव सीन द फॉर्मूला ऑफ फोर्स एफ इन टर्म्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एज एफ इज इक्वल टू अ चार्ज पार्टिकल इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. बट इफ वील कंसिडर दिस चार्ज पार्टिकल एज अ यूनिट, दैट मीन्स क्यू इज इक्वल टू 1, इट्स स्ट्रेंथ इज 1 यूनिट और 1 यूनिटी, देन we can say that F will be equal to E because the value of Q is 1. So here we can say that the electric field due to a charge Q at a point in a space may be defined as the force that a unit positive charge would experience if placed at that point. Q is called a source charge in this case because the electric field is considered of Q only, and this Q is called a test charge. Why it is called a test charge? Because here we are simply going to test the electric field of charge Q by placing this small charge Q. So here the charge of small Q is negligibly small, and so we can say that electric field E is equal to limit Q tends to 0. Why Q tends to 0? Because this charge Q is considered very small, and so Q tends to 0. So E is equal to limit Q tends to 0 F by Q. Now second characteristics of electric field. We know that for any charge particle the electric field prevails around it. So if we'll consider a positive charge, then the direction of electric field will be moving outward, and that is also radially. See, along the radius of a circle these lines will be like a radius, so the word radially is used. And if the charge particle is negative, then again the electric field is radial only, but it will be towards that charge. So we can say that for positive charge the electric field is moving out of that charge, we can say, and for negative charge it is moving towards the charge. So this is about the direction of electric field. Now third characteristics or property of electric field is at equal distances from charge Q the magnitude of electric field is same. Means if we consider a charge Q at any point, then we know that electric field will be like this if it is a positive charge. So these are the electric field, and if I'll select any point here from this point where the charge is kept, then the magnitude of electric field at this much distance will be equal to the magnitude of electric field at same distance at this point. Even if I'll consider this point Then again, if the distance is same, then the magnitude of electric field will be same here also. So at equal distances, this point, this point, this point, this point, which are at equal distances, then we can say that the electric field at these points will be same. So here we must remember one thing, that the electric field at equal distances will be same due to this charge Q, but in terms of magnitude, here the electric field, here there is an electric field, even here there is an electric field, at every point on this circular part the electric field will be same because these distances are same. So in terms of magnitude it is equal, but the direction of electric field at this point will be in this direction. At this point its direction will be this. So as a vector the electric field will be different, but their magnitude is same. So now if we imagine a sphere with a point charge at its center, then the electric field is same at any point on the sphere due to point charge Q. Means if I consider any charged particle at this point, then if I take infinite points around it in three dimension, then by joining that points which are at equal distance, we get a spherical shape in three dimension. You can see this here, it is two dimension, so you can find it is a circular, but in three dimension at equal distances from this point you will get an imaginary sphere. So all the points on the sphere have equal magnitude of electric field because the distance is same, which is nothing but the radius of the sphere. So electric field will be same in terms of magnitude at all the points of this imaginary spherical region. Now let us summarize once again the properties of this electric field. We know that the force F is equal to a charged particle in an electric field. But if we consider this charge as a unit charge, that is Q is equal to 1, then we get the force F is equal to E. Again, when I say that there is a charge particle Q at this point and there is a unit charge Q, then the force will act on this charge due to this charge, because there is an electric field linked with this charge particle Q. Also, there is a electric field due to this small charge Q also, which affects this. But here we'll consider this charge particle as a unit charge, and so this electric field due to charge Q can be considered negligible, and so there is an effect of only charge Q on this charge small q, and there is a very negligible amount of effect on this charge Q due to this. Also, we have studied that if the charge is positive, then the electric field will be outwards. And if the charge is negative, then the electric field will be inwards. Also, if a charge is considered at the center of a sphere, then as it is the center of a sphere, then this distance will be same. So in that case, at this point, at this point, at this point, and every point of the sphere, the magnitude of electric field will be same. As a magnitude, it is same, but the direction is different. Here the direction is this, here the direction is this. So if we'll put a vector, then electric field at this point, suppose point P, will be different than the electric field at point Q. But if I'll not put a vector sign, only put an electric field E, then electric field at point P will be same as at point Q, because the distances are same, and that is radius of the sphere. Now next topic is electric field due to system of charges. See, this is quite similar to the force on a charge due to system of charge, which we have studied in earlier topics. So here also this is quite simple. If we consider charge Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and so on, and if we want to find the electric field at any point P, then here the electric field will be due to all the charges. That is, electric field is due to this charge Q1 also, which is in this direction. Electric field at this point P will be due to charge Q2 also, which is in this direction. Electric field at this point is due to Q3 also and Q4 also. And so the resultant electric field is nothing but it is summation of all the electric fields due to individual charges. And we already know the electric field due to a single charge. That is, if I consider only charge Q1, then at point P the electric field is this. If I consider charge Q2 only, then the electric field at this point is given by this. And so finally the resultant electric field at point P is nothing but it is summation. So this formula is not to remember. We can simply get the solution of the problems or the examples directly without remembering it. So here this summation of electric fields due to individual charges is again due to principle of superposition, which we have used for the forces also. So mathematically we can write the resultant electric field in this way. Now in next topic, only you have to remember that who has given the concept of electric field. The concept of electric field was first introduced by Faraday, which is name of scientist. In our next lecture, we will use the concept of electric field by solving example number 1.8 and example number 1.9. And so the concept of electric field will be clear to you.